Hi everyone, welcome back to another video and another edition, second episode of this Nightmare Builder series. So guys, this is a classic example continuing from the last video that I did about the importance of following procedure before you build. So before you start breaking ground, which is the exciting part, day one, before you do all that, there's a lot of work that needs to be done, and that's very important and critical for the success of your build. One of the important things I mentioned in the last video was drawings, planning, and building regs. Probably the most important being building regs. I'm just going to go through a situation that somebody has had to deal with, and I'm going to try and explain some of the things that you need to do to make sure that you don't fall into these traps and pitfalls. And and hopefully you guys are going to learn something from this. So I'm going to start off reading. There's a couple of posts from this person. Again, this was posted on a forum, a sort of a builder's forum. And I did mention in last video that people use these forums to seek builders. And in this particular instance, the person used the forum to seek a builder. And they ended up having some issues, and so therefore they had some other posts. But we're going to look at two of these posts from this person, and we're going to basically dissect it. So I'm going to start with the first post. So I'm just going to read it out for you guys, and I'll put it on the screen as well as some pictures that this person posted with their post. I'm going to mention the dates as well, the timeline. So the date of these particular two posts, because they're very important. The timeline of this post. So the first post was posted on the 15th of October 2020. So the 15th of October 2020 was the first post. So this is not too long ago, about 6 months ago. So it says, "Hi, looking for a builder who can provide an estimate quote to have a 4 meter extension to the rear of the house, including spanning, squaring up the back corner of the house. Its removal on the conservatory and small extension to the right." I believe he meant it's the removal of the conservatory and a small extension to the right, including the footings, the build, electrics and radiators to finish, including miscoat decor. The extension would need a patio, bifold door and rear window, pitch roof, Velux windows. So this is typically asking for a complete build. It says including the miscoat. So miscoat is basically sort of like an undercoat on fresh plaster. So after the place has been plastered, you give what we call a miscoat, which is sort of like a watered down emulsion, white emulsion, matte emulsion. You've seen us do it on many of our videos. And then typically, or sometimes, a customer will do the final coats themselves. To me, it doesn't make sense unless you're really trying to save money. If you've got a good builder, you can sort of do all of it. It makes sense. They've done all this, and then why not just let the professionals paint it? But you know, sometimes it could be a painter and they want to finish it themselves. So basically they want the full build done, and I'm assuming this is including the materials is what they're looking for, quote for. So we've got some pictures here, so you can see the rear conservatory. There's a small little extension to the right of that conservatory, and they want to knock both of those buildings down, and they just want to build an extension, one unit, one building, the full width of the house, 4 meters deep. Okay, so this is what we're dealing with. What we're going to first look at is a couple of comments, the original comments on this particular post, which are very important. So one of the first comments we can see here is, do you have drawings and specifications? So this is something that I would always ask someone who approaches me about an extension. First thing I would say is, do you have drawings? And a lot of the time I ask for that before I even go out to see a job, because most of the time I can give someone an estimate for the build before I even turn up. Because what happens a lot of the time in my experience is that people have an idea what they want, they go to an architect maybe, or maybe don't go to an architect, and they don't even know how much it's going to cost. So sometimes, you know, you go out there, you spend all this time, you quote it, and then it's sort of out of their budget. So at least with a drawing, I'm able to give you sort of a general ballpark figure which lets the customer know straight away if it's something they can even afford. So if you look at this particular question where someone asked, all planning, building, regulation and other approvals in place. Now the person who made the post, their reply to that person was, we have been advised not required due to the size of extension and need a certificate to say that is the case, question mark. Building regs, etc. to be done during the build. So they're sort of not really even sure at the moment. They're just saying what someone has maybe said to them. I guess what they're saying is due to the size that they don't need planning. And also they said they just need a certificate to say that this is the case. Building regulations, which again is the important one here. It says etc. to be done during the build, question mark. Yes, it's to be done during the build, but it needs to be booked before the build starts. It's very important that building control is informed of the build and has been instructed before you start digging. Very important. It goes on, this person goes on to say, you have been advised incorrectly, speak to and engage a professional. So straight away, someone's given them the correct advice, speak to a professional. The architect should have been able to advise, but I doubt they have an architect because they don't have any planning drawings, so they probably don't have an architect. And also, obviously, they don't have a structural engineer or anything like that. Let's move on forward now. We're jumping about a month from this particular post. So bearing in mind, this is when the post was made seeking a builder, not when the building project started. Okay, so we jump about a month forward to the 18th of November, okay, 18th of November 2020, and the same person has posted another post with some images as well. So we're gonna just go through what this post says, and then I'm gonna explain a couple of things. So it says here, hi all, I'm looking for some advice, please. We've unfortunately had to go separate ways with our current builder. This has left us with a considerable money loss until they give it us back. I need to keep progress going due to a family illness, and I'm looking for some advice for if the building inspector is required, as I've been told different things. The extension is 3 meters from the back of the house and the same width as the house. Foundations have been dug, currently flooded due to weather. Your advice and help would be massively appreciated. And they have a few questions at the bottom here. How do I contact building regs stroke building inspector? How long does this take, as not happened as of yet and need to make quick progress? So there's quite a lot to unpack here. There's a lot of things, and if we keep this in context with the first post, I'm going to try and see if I can explain a couple of things. So I understand this person's mentioning about they need to make quick progress, and it seems that they need to do the progress because of family illness. I'm not sure exactly what the situation is and how this sort of relates to it, but the progress seems to be now based upon their situation. Obviously they have progressed quite quickly as far as getting the build off the ground, because they only posted this a month ago, and a month later they're already in problems with the builder, which means to me, when I think about the timeline, it seems to me that this person has moved very, very quickly, i.e. from the time that they posted to secure a builder, i.e. to get quotes from builders, if they've had multiple quotes, for the builder to come out and to do the quotes, for them to accept the job, for them to order materials, etc., etc., for them to inform building control, for them to start the job, and to be already in issues within 1 month, to me seems as if they were very, very quick to start the job and a bit too hasty. Something I mentioned in the last video, it's really, really important not to, one, be pressured, or yourself to be too hasty about getting a project started. Because, you know, you are dealing with a lot of your hard-earned money. You're dealing with, your investment or your home. So it's something you really need to take your time with. And obviously, you don't want to end up in situations like this. This person is seeking advice, which they did the first time when they had posted they were seeking a builder, and some people were giving advice as far as building control and planning and so on. Now the issue is here, and this is something I see very often, people ask builders, the amount of times people ask me for advice on stuff, and when I tell them the right way or what they should do, whether it's on a build or whether it's something they want to do, they come to you and ask advice, and then they go off and do completely the opposite of what you said, or they don't take any of your advice. It's as if, you know, they sort of like, well, I want to see what the advice is, but I will decide what advice I think is better. So to me, I just think, like, what's the point asking a professional if you're going to make a totally different decision, which is not based upon your own knowledge? You know, some people use Google, they use, well, my friend said whatever, whatever, and they end up getting themselves into problems. Now, there were people who advised on there about building control, and clearly this person did not do it, because they are now asking how do they contact building regs, etc., and how long does it take. Now, as far as contacting building control, there are typically two ways to do this. One, you can usually contact them via your local council. A lot of the times you can do this online now. You don't need to go into your council, or you don't need to call them. You can go online. You can usually fill in an application for building control. You can pay the fee for it. And you can also book your inspections via an online portal as well. So it's very, very easy to do these days. Or you can just call them up and do it yourself. There's other options that there are dedicated building control companies that you can hire. So you can call them up, you can send them the plans, which they are going to want to see, and you can book them for whatever their fee is, and they will handle your inspections on behalf of your local council. And once everything gets ready to be signed off, they will sign it off, and then they will file it with your local council so that your details get updated. So that's the main two ways of doing it. But obviously this person hadn't done on any of it, because they're asking about building regs after the building, the job has already started, so all the foundations are already dug, etc., etc. So I mentioned as well in the other video about specifications and things that your builder cannot say. So for instance, typically when we dig foundations, we tend to dig about a meter deep. It's very typical, especially in London. However, It's not a set thing. Sometimes you can have situations where, for instance, there are trees, roots, large tree roots that are too close to the foundation, and building control may require you to dig, you know, in some cases 3 meters deep, or, you know, if it's not an option, you might have to use piles or stuff like that. So it's not as straightforward as a builder saying, yep, I just dig that. This is why you need to have the structural assessment, and something that building control, that you can sort of use with building control. Although you can dig your foundations and find out that you do need to dig deeper, but it just saves you a lot of that headache. And also you see the situation here where this builder has basically dug the foundations, and the foundations have been sitting and they are filled. That is a lot of water in these foundations. So these foundations, in my opinion, are probably not dug. Probably dug very soon after this post. You know, maybe within the last 2 weeks or so on. And they've obviously had heavy rain and these foundations are flooded. So they're in a situation now where the foundations can be very much compromised. With this level of water, it was not good. It needs to be, if you were in a situation like this, you need to empty this water out ASAP. This is just sort of like a disaster that will happen when people skip and skimp on things that they think are not important. You know, it's amazing that when people don't physically see something, they don't see value in it. So it's like a lot of the hidden stuff. Sometimes, you know, you do work and people don't see the value in the work that you've done, because there's so much work that you don't actually see. And it's funny that a lot of people, when you do sort of like extensions and so on, they put more value in the finishing and the furniture and the kitchen and all these things. And they feel like they don't have a problem spending thousands on a cooker or something. But when it's to do the work and the work that they don't see, they don't see value in the work that you're doing, or you know, what you're creating for them. You know, they would rather spend their money on an expensive kitchen. You know what I mean? So I fully understand how people do this, you know, and why they would think, oh, I don't want to spend £2,000 on an architect, or I don't want to spend money on a structural engineer, because that's money I could be spending on my extension. But the problem is, you could end up losing more than that if you don't do it like this. And as you can see in this situation, this person is saying that the builder has had a considerable sum of money, and they won't give it back. So obviously I don't know the ins and outs, and I don't know if the builder's in the right or the wrong, or if the customer is. This is not really what I'm dealing with here. I'm just dealing with procedure and following the right procedures so that you don't end up in situations like this. So yeah, I just wanted to share this one. I thought this was interesting, and it just sort of piggybacked off the last video that I'd done, and I just wanted to show how common something like this is, and why, when I say it, I really mean this is something that's very common and very, very important. So hopefully none of you guys fall in a situation like this. So yeah, that's it. I just wanted to share this with you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think about this. If you've got anything else to add to this, maybe you've had an experience, unfortunately, or you're another builder, you want to share some more information on this topic that can help people, please do. And yeah, guys, we'll catch up with you on the next video. So until then, take care.